In the vast expanse of our cosmic neighborhood, orbiting the majestic ringed planet Saturn, lies a world of stark contrasts and scientific mysteries, Dione. Named after the Titaness of Greek mythology, Dione's bright, reflective surface hides ancient scars and geological wonders. It's the fourth largest in a system of over 200 known satellites. By diameter, a mere 1,120 kilometers wide, smaller than the width of Texas. Yet despite its modest size, this frozen world holds secrets that continue to captivate planetary scientists and astronomers alike. Today, we journey to this distant moon, a place where icy cliffs rise above cratered plains, where mysterious wispy terrains streak across the surface, and where the forces of orbital resonance have shaped a world unlike any other. I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum, and this is Dione, Saturn's fractured moon. Like many of Saturn's moons, Dione's discovery dates back to the dawn of telescopic astronomy. It was first spotted by the renowned Italian astronomer Giovanni Cassini on the 21st of March, 1684. Cassini, working from the Paris Observatory, had already discovered Saturn's moon Iapetus 2 years earlier, and would go on to discover two more of Saturn's moons, Rhea and Tethys. Initially, Cassini simply called it Saturn IV, denoting it as the fourth moon of Saturn in order of distance. It wouldn't be until 1847 that English astronomer John Herschel suggested using the names of Titans from Greek mythology for Saturn's moons, and thus Dione received its mythological name. The name is fitting. In Greek mythology, Dione was a Titaness, often described as the daughter of Oceanus and Tethys, and sometimes considered one of the consorts of Zeus. Some myths even suggest she was the mother of Aphrodite. Like its mythological namesake, the moon Dione would turn out to have surprising connections and relationships to other bodies in the Saturnian system, but more on that later. For nearly three centuries after its discovery, Dione remained little more than a point of light in our telescopes, a mysterious world about which we knew virtually nothing. Even with Earth's most powerful observatories, this distant moon revealed few of its secrets. All of this would change dramatically with the dawn of the space age. Our first close glimpse of Dione came from NASA's Voyager 1 spacecraft, which flew by the Saturnian system in November 1980. As Voyager approached, Dione began to transform from a mere dot of light into a world with distinct features and character. The Voyager images, though limited by the technology of the time, revealed a moon with a complex surface. Dione appeared heavily cratered on its trailing hemisphere, the side that faces away from its direction of orbit. The largest of these impact craters is Evander, a basin approximately 350 kilometers in diameter. Other significant craters include Aeneas and Dido, named after characters from Virgil's Aeneid. But perhaps most intriguing were the strange bright streaks that crisscrossed portions of its surface. These features, which scientists dubbed wispy terrain, appeared unlike anything seen on other worlds at that time. But with the limited flyby and imaging capabilities, Voyager could only whet our appetite for knowledge about this enigmatic moon. The spacecraft measured Dione's diameter at about 1,120 kilometers, making it Saturn's fourth largest moon after Titan, Rhea, and Iapetus. Voyager also determined that Dione has a density of about 1.48 grams per cubic centimeter, suggesting a composition primarily of water ice with a modest rocky component, likely containing a small silicate core. But the brief encounter left planetary scientists with more questions than answers. What were those mysterious wisps? How did Dione's surface evolve? What forces shaped this distant world? It would take another spacecraft, bearing the name of Dione's Italian discoverer from 400 years ago, to truly begin to unravel these mysteries. In July 2004, NASA's Cassini spacecraft entered orbit around Saturn, beginning what would become a 13-year mission of discovery throughout the Saturnian system. This sophisticated spacecraft carried a suite of scientific instruments that would revolutionize our understanding of Saturn and its moons, and Cassini conducted several close flybys of Dione during its mission, coming as close as 99 kilometers to the moon's surface. These encounters provided unprecedented high-resolution images and a wealth of scientific data about this mysterious world. One of the most significant discoveries came when Cassini revealed the true nature of the mysterious wispy terrain first glimpsed by Voyager. What had appeared as bright, streaky deposits from a distance were actually exposed ice cliffs, the faces of enormous faults cutting through Dione's icy crust. These features, now called Chasmata, are in some cases hundreds of kilometers long and several kilometers deep. The most prominent of these features is Palatine Chasmata, a massive system of fractures stretching more than 600 kilometers across Dione's surface. Other major fracture systems include Padua Chasmata and Carthage Fossae. In some places, these fractures cut through craters and other surface features, indicating they formed relatively recently in Dione's geological history. Dione's density measurements from the Cassini mission confirmed that it is composed primarily of water ice with a significant rock component, roughly 40% rock and 60% ice by mass. This gives Dione a mass of about 1.1 times 10 to the power 21 kilograms. Based on this density and mass, scientists confirm the belief Dione likely has a differentiated interior with a modest rocky core surrounded by a thick mantle of ice. The surface temperature of Dione is extremely cold, averaging about minus 187 degrees Celsius. At those temperatures, water ice behaves like rock does on Earth, allowing for the formation of solid geological features like mountains, craters, and canyons. As mentioned, half of Dione's surface is pocked with craters, signs of ancient impacts. But perhaps more intriguing than the craters are the areas where craters are notably absent. Certain regions of Dione show evidence of resurfacing, geological processes that have erased older features and created smoother plains. These areas, primarily on the leading hemisphere, suggest that Dione has experienced periods of internal activity that has refreshed parts of its surface. But let's talk more about Dione's Chasmata. This bright ice stands in stark contrast to the surrounding older surface material, which has been darkened by exposure to radiation and micrometeorite impacts over billions of years. But what caused these enormous fractures? The leading theory is that they formed in response to global stress patterns in Dione's icy crust. As Dione cooled and evolved over billions of years, its crust would have experienced tension and compression forces that ultimately led to fracturing. Some scientists believe these fractures may be evidence that Dione once had a subsurface ocean that froze over time. As water expands when it freezes, the growth of ice would have placed enormous stress on the outer crust, potentially causing it to crack in the patterns we see today. Others suggest that tidal flexing, the stretching and squeezing of Dione due to Saturn's gravitational pull, may have generated enough heat and stress to create these features. We still don't have the full answers. Dione orbits Saturn at a distance of about 377,400 kilometers, completing one orbit every 2.7 Earth days. Dione is tidally locked to Saturn, meaning the same side always faces the planet, just as our moon always shows the same face to Earth. Like many moons in the Saturnian system, Dione participates in a global dance of orbital resonances that has profound implications for its evolution. Perhaps the most significant of these relationships is the 2-1 mean motion resonance Dione shares with Enceladus. This means that for every orbit Dione completes around Saturn, Enceladus completes exactly 2 orbits. This is not merely a coincidence. It's a gravitational relationship that has locked these two moons into a synchronized pattern that affects both worlds. This resonance creates tidal forces that generate heat within both moons. However, the effects are much more dramatic on Enceladus, which shows extraordinary geologic activity, including its famous southern polar geysers that continuously erupt water ice into space. Dione, being larger, experiences proportionally less tidal heating from this relationship. And did you know Dione also has its own small satellites? Two tiny moons named Helena and Polydeuces orbit Saturn at the same distance as Dione. These moons occupy what is known as Lagrange points in Dione's orbit, stable gravitational points that precede and follow Dione as it circles Saturn. These tiny moons, sometimes called Trojan moons, are just a few kilometers across and are likely captured or formed from debris in Dione's orbital vicinity. But what about that subsurface ocean? The possibility is certainly intriguing. Scientists are always fascinated with any such location around the solar system due to all oceans' potential to be the birthing place of life. So the existence of an ocean would be significant on Dione, and it's not without evidence. Cassini's magnetometer detected a weak interaction between Dione and Saturn's magnetosphere, which some scientists interpret as evidence for a conductive layer beneath the surface, possibly a salty subsurface ocean. The extensive fracture systems on Dione's surface also suggest significant geological activity in its past, which could have been driven by the presence of liquid water below. Models of Dione's internal heat budget, considering radioactive decay in its rocky core and tidal heating from its orbital resonance with Enceladus, suggest it may have generated enough heat throughout its history to maintain a liquid layer between its core and icy crust. If Dione does harbor a subsurface ocean, it would join a growing list of ocean worlds in our solar system, places like Europa, Enceladus, and possibly Titan, that could potentially provide habitable environments for simple forms of life. However, unlike Enceladus with its dramatic plumes of water vapor erupting into space, Dione shows no current signs of geological activity that would provide easy access to any subsurface ocean. If an ocean exists within Dione, it remains well hidden beneath kilometers of ice. Since the end of the Cassini mission in 2017, when the spacecraft was deliberately plunged into Saturn's atmosphere, no other spacecraft has visited the Saturnian system. This means our current understanding of Dione is based entirely on the data collected during these limited encounters with Cassini and Voyager. However, the scientific community has proposed several concepts for future missions to the Saturn system that could include further exploration of Dione. These include orbiter missions that would study multiple moons of Saturn, landers that could touch down on Dione's surface, and even specialized missions to search for signs of a subsurface ocean. One particularly ambitious concept is the Enceladus orbiter, which would primarily study Enceladus, but could potentially make multiple flybys of Dione as well. Another proposal, called the Journey to Enceladus and Titan, would similarly focus on those two moons, but include observations of Saturn's other major satellites, including Dione. While none of these mission concepts have been approved for development, the scientific questions raised by our limited exploration of Dione ensure that it remains a compelling target for future study. As we draw back from our close examination of Dione, we're left with a portrait of a world of fascinating contrasts. A moon whose seemingly static, icy surface tells a story of a dynamic past. The extensive networks of bright fractures that crisscross its surface speak to powerful forces that have shaped and reshaped this world throughout history. The striking difference between its cratered trailing hemisphere and smoother leading face hints at ongoing processes that continue to sculpt its features, and subtle clues in its gravitational and magnetic signatures whisper the possibility of a hidden ocean below its frozen exterior. In many ways, Dione exemplifies the surprising complexity we've discovered throughout Saturn's system of moons. What once appeared as mere points of light in our telescopes have been revealed as unique worlds with their own geological characters and evolutionary histories. These discoveries challenge us to rethink our understanding of what drives geological activity in the outer solar system, where the heat of the sun is too distant to power the processes we see on Earth. In the vast symphony of Saturn's moons, Dione plays its own distinct melody, one that continues to fascinate and inspire us to look deeper into the mysteries of our solar system. Of course, not all the universe's wonders are far away. You may have heard that I recently launched a new channel, Astrum Earth, dedicated to exploring the amazing phenomena and features of our own planet. Its first video about the AMOC, a massive series of ocean currents that is shaping the face of our climate, is already live. But that's not all. If you love being an early bird, you can see our second Astrum Earth video right now over on my Patreon. It's all about the enigmatic Bermuda Triangle, something that has always fascinated me. I love the videos we've been making on the new Astrum Earth channel, so if you're looking for a way to support Astrum as a whole, why not see for yourself our closer examinations of the breathtaking world that we call home? Links are in the description below. Thanks for watching. I really want to give a huge thank you to our astronauts on Patreon. It's really becoming a thriving community, and I've loved reading all your messages and comments over there. If you'd like to join in, then you can visit the link in the description to become an astronaut and bring the channel more stability than the algorithm. When you join, you'll be able to watch the whole video ad-free, see your name in the credits, and submit questions to our team. Meanwhile, click the link to this playlist for more Astrum content. I'll see you next time.